5 months on and Birkenhead's massive slip still something of a local attraction, but its attention those living alongside it can do without.
Even if we decided to move, who wanna buy the place? Nobody, only somebody who doesn't know about the hole, but everybody knows.
Making matters even worse for some is the watch and wait approach recommended in a specially commissioned geotechnical report amid concerns about the land stability.
They went out to a professional engineering firm and that firm recommended doing the monitoring. With hindsight, you can throw all sorts of criticisms around, but the truth is they followed the best advice they could get.
What else are they going to say? To put it bluntly, you're hardly going to say, well, actually, we're scurrying around because there is a problem, we should do something about it.
Monitoring saw specialist engineers checking the land monthly for 2 years prior to it giving way, but more expensive stabilising options were never actioned.
They knew something wasn't right with the soil. Instead of do something straight away, they just, like say, observe. And you observe and nothing happened.
It's a question of assessing the risks, and it's really, really hard to work out what the probability of a failure is for a natural slope or a man-made slope.
The task of repair now slow and steady.
Other locals we've spoken to say they're satisfied with progress here and the information they're receiving in regular email updates. But there is some concern that a boutique hotel is one option on the table for this land when it's finally stabilised.
That's upsetting locals too, who say the council now owes the community a say in what happens next.
Please don't cut and run and hand it over to a developer, because really you are neglecting your responsibilities when you do that.
Any decision still a long way off, the priority now stabilising the land and reassuring locals their homes are safe. Nicole Bremner, One News.